Hello everyone, welcome to the new part of link tutorial, and in this video we will learn about the quantifier operations. We will learn what are quantifier operations, then where and why should we use quantifier operations, and what are the different methods available in this category. First, let's understand what are the quantifier operations. Quantifier operations are used on a data source to check if some or all elements of that data source satisfy a condition or not. So in this scenario, we have a data source and we have a condition, and then we need to check whether all the elements or some of the elements of that data source satisfy the specified condition that we already have with us. All the methods in quantifier operations return a boolean value. So the return type of all the methods is either true or false based on the condition. If element satisfied the condition, then the return type will be true or the return type will be false. Condition may be for some or all the elements. So as I told you in the previous sentence, that the condition may be for some of the elements or all the elements of the data source. So to understand it better, let's understand what may be the examples of quantifier operations. First example is, suppose we have a class of students, and in that class we need to check whether all the students are present for a particular day or not. So basically we are just checking true or false. So the condition is that all the students should present in the class, and the data source is class of students. So basically we are just checking whether all the students of the class are present for a particular day. So in this scenario, if all the students are present, then the return will be true. If anyone of them is absent, then the return type will be false. Next example is, suppose in a class of students we need to check if any student has number more than 80%. So in this scenario we are looking only for one element. There may be some element or there may not be some element. If in the class of students we have any one student who has his number more than 80%, then the return will be true. If we don't have any student with numbers more than 80%, then the return type will be false. Next is, we need to check if a class of students has any student with name Bob. So basically we need to check whether our data source has some element based on the condition. Suppose the condition is that I'm looking for a particular student and the name of the student is Bob. So basically I need to check if any of the student has name Bob in the class of the students. And there may be lot of examples for this quantifier operations. So this is one of the most used operations in the link query. Now let's see what are the different methods available in quantifier. First we have all. The name of the method is all, and this all method is used to check whether all the elements of a data source satisfy a condition. The condition is that all the elements of that data source should satisfy that condition individually. If any of the element is not satisfying the condition, then the return type will be false. If all of them are satisfying the condition individually, then the return type will be true. Next is any. Any is used whether at least one element or any element of a data source satisfy a condition. If any of the element of the data source satisfy the condition, then the return type will be true. Otherwise, if no element of the data source satisfy the condition, then the return type will be false. The last one is the contains method. The contains is used to check whether the data source has some element with our given value. So in this scenario, we will give the value and we will check whether the data source contains that value or not. So this is used for that purpose. In the next part, we will learn all these methods in details one by one. So thank you for watching. Have a great day.